The virtual private network, the name is telling you that it's a virtual. Virtual means it's an imaginary type of thing. And we are going to establish a private network. Private is nothing but it is only the conversation between sender and receiver. No one can interrupt in between that. That is what is called private means. Here, virtual private network means we are going to establish a private network on the public infrastructure. So the public infrastructure is nothing but the general internet, okay, and the internet provided by the internet service provider. These kind of things are the public internet or public infrastructure. On the public infrastructure, we are going to establish the secure connection between the sender and receiver. This is called private network or private communication. So that is the reason we will call it as a virtual private network. For example, here is the system, which is a user system. It wants to establish the communication with either maybe a server at one organization, or this particular system wants to communicate with a computer at another organization. So whenever two people or two computers want to communicate in a secure way, obviously there should be a dedicated connection, and also a private connection must be established. Like how, we might have seen in our news and all also, if two country heads want to speak some issues, or if they want to discuss the matters related to their country, so what they will do is they will establish a hotline. Hotline is nothing but it is a dedicated private line, so that no one can interrupt in between that, so that the country secrets and what are the secrets they discuss cannot be leaked out. So this is what is called the hotline. This is the dedicated line. So in the same way, a computer want to establish a private or secure communication with a server on one organization, or maybe with the a computer on which is available on the organization, then it want to establish a private network. If it want to establish a private network, obviously a dedicated channel must be there. But if you look at, assume that this computer is used by you, and you are a security engineer of your organization, and you may go anywhere in the country, or sometimes you may go out of the country also. But you must be in a position to access the organization server, so that the security monitoring can be done by you. Then, wherever you go in the country, or wherever, because of your business and because of your work, you may travel along over the country, or you may travel over anywhere. Sometimes, because of this current pandemic, you may work at you may sit at home and you may work from your home to monitor the security operations of the server at the organization. But in such a case, can you establish a dedicated link, or we can say, can you establish a leased line always to have communication? No, it is not possible. So obviously, you have to use the general public infrastructure, whatever the internet provided by the general internet service providers, either maybe a BSNL broadband, or maybe Jio broadband, or Airtel broadband, whatever the broadband is there, you may use the public infrastructure. But even you use public infrastructure, the communication between you and the organization server must be a private. So that is the reason we are going to use this particular virtual private networks concept. And in order to communicate with the organization server, you will establish a tunnel. A tunnel is one which will be having an entry point and exit point. And at an entry point, you can check what you can send. And at the entry at the exit point also, you can verify what you have sent at the entry point. So whenever because in tunnel means you cannot inject anything in middle, okay, in middle of the tunnel. So that is the reason we'll call it as a tunnel, which is a secure and private channel. So this particular tunnel must be established over the public infrastructure. In order to establish this tunnel, we may use several protocols. And several protocols such as generic routing encapsulation protocol, point-to-point tunneling protocol, layer two tunneling protocol, IPsec, that is called secure IP or IP security, MPLS, Multi-Protocol Label Switching. So these are the various protocols that you can use for the tunneling operation. This tunneling, where you do this tunneling? This tunneling will be used for establishing the secure private channel over the public infrastructure, which are called internet. Okay? So in order to establish that secure private channel, we'll use this, any kind of this protocol. But if you perform the tunneling at a layer 2 is nothing but data link layer. And a computer, there is ISO OS, a reference layer, just to recall it, in which you will be having the data link layer. The data link layer is the layer 2. That means if you establish a tunnel, secure tunnel at the data link layer between the sender and receiver, then it's said to be layer 2 virtual private network. It's the same if you establish at the layer 3, then it's said to be the layer 3 virtual private network. Layer 3 is the network layer that you are all aware of. That is the where you will be having the IP internet protocol and its related thing, which is called ICMP also, and supporting protocols. So that means layer 3 virtual private network. So this is the way the tunneling will be done on the private on the public infrastructure to have the secure communication. This is the concept of the virtual private network. So in order to perform the tunneling, we use these protocols, in which IP security is the best protocol that can be easily configured. And also many of the operating systems, including Windows, Linux, and all these operating systems are having the IP security as a feature in their firewall settings. So it is not a big task for everyone to configure the IP security features in the firewall settings, so that whatever the packet you send, that will be having a security attached to it. So that is the reason IPsec has become very famous and has popularly used nowadays, compared to the protocols such as GRE, PPTP, L2TP, MPLS. Okay, so that is the reason we are going to discuss the IP security nowadays, which is popularly used by the industry, and also for establishing the secure channels with other, not only with VPN, with other type of secure establishments also. So that is the reason we are going to see the IP security in this lecture. And also we have seen the open virtual private network software that has a feature that it won't use the IP security. But what it will use? It will use the SSL or TLS. Okay? So IP security is an inbuilt feature nowadays supported by the operating systems. So that is the reason we are studying this IP security. And also, if you use any open virtual private network softwares or open VPNs, then they are using the open SSL library, which supports the secure socket layer or transport layer security on TCP or UDP. That is the reason our next topic that we are going to discuss is the SSL or TLS. And not only this SSL and TLS is not only used for the virtual private network, but also to have the secure communication over the hypertext transfer protocol. So that the HTTP plus SSL is said to be HTTPS protocol, which is called hypertext transfer protocol with secure socket layer security. So we all because of the browsing experience and all, we have seen HTTPS is more secure compared to HTTP. That everyone is aware of this particular feature. The reason is HTTP don't have the security mechanism and HTTPS have the security mechanism. That security mechanism is established from the transport layer itself. So that is the reason we'll call it as a secure socket layer or transport layer security that is widely used by the OpenSSL library, which is available in the OpenSSL library and used by the open VPNs. So SSL is not only for the secure web browser and secure web communications, but also for the virtual private network implementation. So that is the reason, as part of this course, we are going to see the IP security and also the secure socket layer and transport layer security. Now we'll move on to the IP security. In the IP security, IP means internet protocol. That already we are aware of the internet protocol, working of the internet protocol, and the internet protocol that will come in two versions, IPv4 and IPv6. IPv4 is of 32 bit and IPv6 of 128 bit. So that all we are aware of. But if you add security feature to it, to the internet protocol, then it is to be IP security. What are the security features that are available? So the IPsec provides the access control. So access control means user authentication here, the data integrity, data origin authentication, that means from where the data is originated, the data origin authentication, rejection of replayed attack or replayed packets. Replayed packets is nothing but in general, we are aware of that in TCP communication, if the packet was lost, obviously the communication will be going to the sender that the packet has been lost. So that sender can replay the same packet or send the same packet. So sometimes this replay packet may also be done by the attacker by spoofing into the network. So that is the reason it has a protection for replayed packets also. Next one, the most important thing is confidentiality. That means once you want to communicate with in secure channel, whatever the data you want to transmit over the channel, that can be encrypted and sent. So that the encryption will provide us the confidentiality that we have studied in the principles of cybersecurity, that is especially the principles of the cryptography. Confidentiality, authentication, integrity, and non-repudiation. These are the properties. So in that, confidentiality was provided by the IP security. And also limited traffic flow confidentiality. So traffic flow can also be monitored perfectly with the help of this particular IPsec. So IPsec provides these features. And what is the benefit of this particular IPsec? Security at layer 3 applies to all transport or applications. So that is layer 3 means what is the layer 3? Network layer. Can be implemented in firewall or router. So this is the beautiful feature. I told you just now that IPsec is nowadays offered by the operating systems as part of the firewall. So you can implement it in firewall or at the router level. In routers also, even Cisco routers or D-Link routers, these routers are also providing the features of the IP security. Secure to do all traffic crossing the perimeter. Perimeter is nothing but the network perimeter of any organization. The network perimeter is nothing but the network perimeter may be consisting of a server, okay, and a router and a switch, then network. So this entire thing is combinedly you can call it as the perimeter. So whatever the traffic that will come into this perimeter of the organization network, that can be taken care of. Transparent to applications, that can be transparent to the end users, and can provide security for individual users also, not only for the organization or not only for the company or broader level, but also we can provide the security at the individual users. And what are the applications of this IP security? Virtual private networks, branch offices can communicate in a secure way, remote users can also communicate in a secure way, and extranets. So that means IP security is not only used in virtual private networks, but also between the branch offices for secure communication, and also for the remote users for secure communication and extranets. So these are the other applications of the IP security along with the virtual private networks. So that is the reason, don't get confused that if anyone say IP security, don't say it as a virtual private network. If anyone say virtual private network, don't say it as a IP security. This is the most confusing part of the thing for the students. So that is the reason IP security is different. IP security is a protocol that can be used for establishing the secure tunnel via public network to establish a virtual private network. Okay. Next, what are the IP security services, main services in the IP security? In IP security, two main services are two main protocols that are used are, one is authentication header, second one is encapsulating security payload. This is up to the user to decide based upon the requirement of the secure communication, how much secure the communication must be. Based on that, the user can decide whether he can go for choosing of the AH service or ESP service when they want to implement the IP security. the authentication header service and encapsulating security payload service. So that means while you are configuring the IP security, which service that you want to utilize. What are the differences between these two services? The services will be like this. Access control, we have seen it, IP security provides, these are the services at all. Now, what are the general services that are required, that are in general looking for by the organization or by the individual? First one is access control. Access control is there in both authentication header and encapsulating security payload. That means if anyone wants authentication, access control, then they can configure either authentication or ESP. And next one is message authentication. Message integrity, both are having the features of message integrity. Entity authentication, that is the data source authentication. From where this data was originated, that entity authentication you require, then that entity authentication was provided by both AH and ESP. Confidentiality. Confidential means encryption of the data that you are going to send over the terminal or the tunnel. So authentication header don't have the confidentiality feature and ESP has the confidentiality feature. Replay attack protection. The authentication has the feature of replay attack protection. At the same time, ESP also have the replay attack protection. That means if you want confidentiality via the secure tunnel, then don't use authentication header. You use ESP. Okay. That means authentication header will not provide the confidentiality. When the confidentiality was not provided, automatically the privacy of the user will be compromised. So that means if you configure the virtual private network via IPsec, use ESP so that the privacy cannot be compromised. So this is what the summary we can say. This is the take home points we can say from the IP security. If you want to use IP security as part of the implementation of the virtual private network, and if you require access control, message authentication, entity authentication, confidentiality, and replay attack protection for all these features, then you use encapsulating security payload. If you don't want privacy is not a big matter for you, then you can use authentication header. These are the two main protocol services that are offered in the IP security. Now we'll move on to the IPsec architecture. The IPsec architecture will be like this. At the sender end and at the receiving end, you will be having security policy database. When you configure the IPsec, you will be having one security policy database, which consisting of the Internet Key Exchange version 2 will be there, and another subcomponent called the Internet Protocol Security version 3 will be there. And this Internet Key Exchange protocol will maintain a security association database. Security association database is nothing but to which receiver or to which sender or to which second party we are communicating and what are the key pairs of the communicating party. That details will be available in the security association database. The same is the case with the second end also. So that is Internet Key Exchange version 2 and IPsec version 3 and security association database. Obviously, in order to maintain the encryption or confidentiality, obviously to perform the encryption, we require some keys that we have studied in the public key cryptography, or we have seen in the symmetric or asymmetric key cryptography. So this key exchange will be done with this with the help of this Internet Key Exchange protocol. And then Internet Key Exchange Security Association will be established. Then, after establishing the security association related key exchange, then IPsec security association pair will be established, will be used to connect between the IP security protocol version 3 here and at the sender and at the receiver. Then, based upon the service, that is either whether you are going to use authentication header or ESP. For example, here ESP is there, they might have used. Then ESP protects the data with the help of these keys that what they have generated and exchanged and available in the security association database. Based on that, the encryption will be done and the data will be sent over the secure channel. This is what the ESP protection data that is going to be transmitted between the sender and receiver with the help of the keys that are available here. So these are the four main things. Internet key exchange. This is the total architecture: internet key exchange, IP security, security association database, and security policy database. Now we'll see one by one. Security association database. Each host has a database of security associates. So this is the security associations. Each particular system which is participating in the IP security will be having the security association database. Each host has a database of security association. Security association is one-way security relationship between sender and receiver. Two-way may use different security. That is called two security associations required for that. Okay, one security association will hold one security relation between the sender and receiver. If you want from receiver to sender also, another security association must be used. All these security associations will be stacked into the security association database. And it is defined by three parameters. The security association is defined by three parameters. One is security parameter index. Another is IP destination address. And third one is security protocol identifier. That means either you are using authentication header or the encapsulating security payload. We have seen here the two protocols that you can use with the IP security. For each security association, the database consisting of security parameter index, sequence number counter and counter overflow flag, anti-replay window, authentication header information and ESP information, lifetime of the security association. This is a very, very important thing in the key management. Security association cannot be stayed for long time. Always, the security associations should be refreshed periodically. The reason is, if the same key, same security association and its related keys have been used for a long time, there is a chance of learning of the association by the attacker and may devise a strategy to break the particular association. That is the reason there will be a lifetime of security association. Once that time is over, then again the same operations, whatever we are going to see in the diagram, will be established, and then fresh communication will be established. Or the if any communication is going on, then that communication will be again re-established as it is by changing the keys and the security associations. And mode, transport or tunnel mode or wildcard mode. These are the mode of communication between the sender and receiver whenever you use IP security. Transport mode or tunnel mode, that we'll see afterwards. And path MTU, maximum transmission unit over the particular secure path, that will be decided. So that means each security association consisting of these features, these parameters. Okay, one is security parameter index, another is sequence number counter and counter overflow flag. It is especially to maintain what is the counter count of the packet sent and received. Anti-reply window, authentication header information and ESP information, lifetime of security association, and mode of transport, that is either tunnel mode, transport mode or wildcard mode, and path MTU, maximum transmission unit over the path. And security policy database. Security policy database will consisting of the table like this. What is the protocol used? What is the local IP address, port, remote port? What is the action? If the packet comes, a UDP packet comes, then what is the action? That will go for bypass and bypass this particular packet. And if it is from any protocol, and what could be the action? Protect ESP in transport mode. So So if it is a transport mode of ESP, then how to do this? That is just to go for checking of the protection of the data. Like that, this access control mechanism, a policy mechanism, will be maintained as a table in this particular security policy database. Relates IP traffic to specific security associations. Match subnets of IP traffic to relevant security associations. IP traffic is nothing but, we have seen in the virtual private network diagram that an organization may have many number of computers, and all these computers may be divided into several subnets. And and whenever the secure channel is established in a tunnel mode between the router to router, obviously under router there may be having several subnets. So what are the subnets to be allowed to access this particular IP security or virtual private network that is established via this IP security? And its labels will be mentioned, and its policy mechanisms will be mentioned in this table like this. So use selectors to filter outgoing traffic to map based on local and remote IP address, next layer protocol, name, local and remote ports. So these are the policy databases that will be mentioned. Now we'll see transport mode and tunnel mode of operations of the IP security. Transport mode operation is nothing but, you want to establish a secure tunnel between a computer to computer directly. That is what being called transport mode tunnel. Okay, transport mode operation of the IP security. So in the transport mode, what will happen? What are the transport layer data will be there? That will be added in the IP security layer, and the IP security headers will be added to this. Then the network layer, then that particular data will be sent over the secure channel and directly to the host B, because the IP security consisting of what is the association here? You look at what is the thing? IP destination address. So whenever you say IP destination address, automatically whatever the IP destination, whatever the IP is there, to whom you are supposed to send it, that particular IP directly it will go. Okay. And here the same operation which has happened at the sender, in a reverse operation, the reverse operation will be happened and the data will be taken over by the application layer. This is called transport mode. In transport mode, direct computer to computer. In tunnel mode, what will happen? This is a router of the sender. For example, you are sitting at home and you want to establish a communication between the between yourself and your organization server. Now you may be having a router at your home. From this router to the router of the organizational network. Okay. Now you are going to establish a secure tunnel between this router and this router. But in case of transport mode, what happened? Directly from the computer to computer. Now here, from the router to router. So in this transport mode, in the tunnel mode, what will happen? From the router to router. Because under this router, you may have any number of computers connected to this router. Right? Any number of computers connected to this router. And also we have seen this IP security can be established as part of firewall or as part of the router also. So the routers that supports the IP security may be configured like this, and to establish and also can be established a communication between the router and router in a tunnel fashion. So that means this IP security can be implemented either in the transport mode or in maybe the tunnel mode. So here secure channel will be established between the router and router. Okay, that you are supposed to aware of. So in this tunnel mode, you don't consider the transport. There is no security for the transport mode data or transport layer data. It will always start from the network layer only, because routers are responsible for the data link layer, physical layer, data link layer, and network layer only. Above layers are not the part of the routers. Okay, but computer is like a host which is having all features of all the seven layers. But in case of router, you will be having the features of only the physical layer, data link layer, and the network layer. Transport layer is not the part of the router. So that is the reason in internal mode, you will be having the network layer, IPsec layer, and the network layer, final network layer. So whatever the network layer data will be there, that will be added in the IP security header, and finally that will be sent to the other router where the secure connection is established. Okay, but in case of transport mode security or transport mode in action, transport layer header will be encapsulated in the IP security header, then to the network layer, from there the communication will go on. That is what the main difference between the transport and the tunnel mode. It is up to you to decide, okay, from which mode you want to establish. In general, the tunnel mode of operation will be majorly used because you might have think of you are sitting at your home and you are connecting to your router, and from there to the organizational network or organizational server. Obviously, the organizational network may be using this router, and they may be configured this router with the with this particular secure IP security, so that from this to this, the secure channel will be established. So in the transport mode, IP security in the transport mode does not protect IP header. It only protects the information coming from the transport layer. So only transport layer data information will be protected and encapsulated in the IP headers. In the IP security tunnel mode, protects the original IP header. Whatever the original IP header generated at the sender end will be protected via IP security. That is what the main difference. And also the connection is from computer to computer in case of transport mode, where from the router to router in case of the tunnel mode. Now we'll see remaining other features of this IP security. IP security can be operated in two modes. One is authentication header mode, AH mode, another is ESP mode. First, authentication header mode. The authentication header protocol provides source authentication and data integrity, but not privacy. We have seen in the beginning itself, privacy will be maintained using confidentiality. Confidentiality feature is not available in the authentication header. Data used in calculation of authentication data, except those fields in the IP header changing during the transmission. Only that particular data will be having like this, the original IP header, authentication header will be attached to the original IP header, and transport layer payload and padding. You might have studied in the computer networks also, the packet structure. The regular packet structure IP header, to that this authentication header is attached. And for this authentication header, transport layer for payload will be attached. Like that, the encapsulation and encapsulation of the data from while coming from the application layer to the lower layer that you have already studied in the computer networks, the same feature wherever it comes to the IP network layer, the authentication header is added. What is this authentication header? It consisting of the 8 bits for the next header, payload for the payload length of 8 bits, and reserved. This is the reserved bits, okay, and security parameter index, sequence number, authentication data. This authentication data is the one where whatever the data used in calculation of authentication data, whatever the authentication data is there, that data consisting of the source authentication and from where this particular data is originated, and this information will be hashed via secure hash algorithms, either maybe SHA-1 or maybe MD5. Some secure hash algorithms will be used, and that digest. Okay, whatever the digest that will come after that particular secure hash algorithm, after implementing secure hash algorithm, that digest will be placed here. Okay, that digest will be placed here. Whenever receiver receives this authentication header, it will check all the things, and also the authentication data, what is original authentication data. Again, it will do the same. It will be applying the same cryptographic hash function, and will generate the digest. And that digest and the digest sent by the sender, both these digests will be compared. If both digests are equal, then the packet will be accepted, otherwise packet will be rejected. In order to do that, this integrity check value, that is what is called the authentication header integrity check value, is computed over how this particular ICV, that is integrated check, will be computed. this will be computed over IP header feeds that are either immutable in transit or that are predictable in the value upon arrival of the endpoint for the authentication header. It will be consisting of source address, destination address, and source routing. Authentication header, that is the next header, payload length, reserved SPI sequence number, authentication data. The upper layer protocol data, which is assumed to be immutable in transit. All these things will be hashed via using secure hash function, and a digest will be generated. That digest will be added in the authentication header at the end and will be sent out to the sender, to the receiver. Now the receiver, what it will do, based upon the features that are added to perform the cryptographic hash function, all these things which are available in this particular main packet, that will be extracted and will do the same cryptographic hash, will apply the same cryptographic hash function and will generate the message digest, and that message digest and this message digest will be compared. If both are equal, then this packet will be accepted. Next, while coming to the encapsulating security payload, this is the second mode of operation. In this encapsulating security payload mode, you will be having the privacy feature also. This privacy feature will be you will get via encryption. So regular IP header, ESP header, which consisting of 32 bits, security parameter index, sequence number, transport layer payload, and ESP trailer. So this transport layer payload and ESP trailer will be encrypted. Okay, will be encrypted using the key exchanged. Using the key exchanged during this particular establishment during the connection. So this encryption will be done here, and this encrypted data will be placed in the packet, and finally the authentication data, which was computed by a cryptographic hash function, will also be added. So at the receiving end, as usually like authentication header, it will be done, the verification will be done. But during the transit, if any attacker spoof this particular packet, but still he cannot get the original data that is transmitting over the secure channel, the reason is the data is encrypted. So unless until they know the key and the security association details, that attacker cannot know the original data. That is what is called, that is what the advantage of the ESP that provides source authentication, data integrity, and privacy. So ESP provides message content confidentiality, data origin, authentication, connectionless integrity, anti-replay services, limited traffic flow confidentiality, service depend on options selected when while establishing the security association, network location, and can use a variety of encryption and authentication algorithms in the ESP. So here, simple inbound and outbound security association rules. The outbound security association rules, from the Alice, Bob, you are supposed to send to Bob. That means here IP address of the Bob should be there. Protocol, ESP, authentication. Either you use SHA-1 or SHA-256, that is up to you. And this is the key X, encryption. Encryption, it may using data encryption standard, and with the key Y that will be sent to the from the Alice via this mode. Then IP security packet was sent received by the Bob will verify it, and it will come to know that okay, it was received from Alice. That means Alice IP address will be there, and the protocol used is ESP. So when it is ESP, it has to check for the encryption also. That means it has to decrypt with the key, but it was already established between them. And once it is established, whatever the original data you will get, all this data will be sent on to the cryptographic hash function SHA-1, and the message digest will be verified with the message digest that was sent over this particular packet. So if both are equal and encryption is successful, obviously if encryption is successful, the original data will be used for the cryptographic hash function, and if the message digest is equal, then the data will be read by the Bob. So in this transit, if any attacker wants to spoof this packet, IPsec packet, they can spoof it, but they will not get this particular information. So that is what the advantage of this IP security, and this can be implemented over the virtual private network. And while coming to the anti-replay service, sender initializes the sequence number to zero when a new security association is established. obviously security association periodically will change. Whenever the security association is changed, then the sequence number will become zero and increment for each packet. Receiver then accept packet with the sequence number like this. This is the sequence number minus W means window size plus 1. This is the way it will accept. We have seen, you might have studied the sliding window protocol in the TCP. The sliding window protocol means the protocol will be having this window kind of thing, which will be having how many packets were sent, how many packets received, and what are the packets require acknowledgement. This kind of window will be maintained here. So here n minus w, that is the number of packets sent minus the window minus window size, and n plus 1 here, and here marked if the valid packet received. So the particular packet is received and it is valid. How can you say it is valid? Because they will verify the cryptographic hash message digest, and if it is valid, then it is valid. So if it is valid, then mark if valid packet is received, unmark if the packet is not yet received, or unmarked if valid packet not yet received. Then corresponding acknowledgement or corresponding reply will be sent, so that the sender may retransmit the same packet. So this is what the anti-reply service. So this anti-reply service having the keep track of what are the packets received and what are the packets not received. So thereby, if any attacker inject the duplicate packet also, it easily can verify that whether the same type of packet has been received or not. If it is received, obviously the packet will be discarded. Combining security associations. In how many ways you can combine the security associations? Security association can be implemented either the authentication header or ESP that we are aware of. That is up to the user to choose the service. To implement both, need to combine security association to form a security association bundle. More that means high security to be if you want to establish high level security, these security associations can be combined in various ways. That is what is called iterated tunneling. Instead of having a single tunnel, iterative tunneling can be made. How? All security between the end systems, authentication header transport, ESP transport, ESP inside authentication header transport, any one of the first three inside authentication header transport. Like that, you can make the combinations to make your secure channel to channel more secure. Between gateways, that is, either you may establish the channel between the routers and firewalls, single security association, and no nesting in that. Case one inside case two, that means this may be used in between the routers or maybe firewalls. Case one inside case two. Tunnel between a remote host and a firewall. One or two security associations may use in the case one. So like that, you can have any combinations to make your channel secure. For example, this is the one or more security associations. Here local intranet, again router. Here some security association between this, again internet, router, local intranet, and host. And between the host and a host, you may be having a tunnel. And this tunnel may be between this router and this router, this security gateway and this security gateway. And from the security gateway to the local host, you may be having one security association. And from this gateway to this host, one security association. Between this router and this router, there may be a tunnel. Okay. And there may not be having any security association between this gateway to the local host, but there may be a tunnel between the router and this router, or we can say this gateway and this gateway. Okay. And there may be a secure tunnel between the host and router, and there may be a single association between the router and host. So like this, in any combination, many combinations, okay, in any combinations between the host, sender and receiver, whatever the network devices you are having, you can establish the secure channels using IP security. That is what the flexibility, because of this flexibility, it is widely used. Okay. So the internet key exchange component, if you look at finally, it will be having two main things. One is OKLE and SKEME. These are the two main features available in this internet key exchange component. OKLE is handles key generation and distribution typically need two pair of keys, two per direction for integrity and confidentiality, mutual key management, that is system admin manually configure every system, automated key management, that means here by default this IKEA itself will generate some keys dynamically and will go for exchange. So Oracle key exchange and ISAKMP key management. And this we have seen in the diagram, it is using IKE version 2. IKE version is no longer uses the Oracle, but it is using the ISAKMP terms. But basic functionality is same either in the Oracle or this one. We are not discussing how this Oracle function and all, but I'm explaining what it is internally using. So ISAKMP is the Internet Security Key Association and Key Management Protocol, provides framework for key management. Key management consisting of key generation, key refreshment, key rekeying, and saving of the key. Define procedures and packet format to establish, negotiate, modify, and delete security association. Independent of key exchange protocol, encryption algorithm, and authentication. So to conclude the IP security provides authentication, confidentiality, and key management at layer 3, and it applies to all traffic. Security associations are one way and can be bundled together, as we have seen previously, case 1 within case 2, case 2 within case 3, just like that. Authentication header for message authentication, that is key hashed message authentication, will be used in this particular IP security. Encapsulating security payload for confidentiality and for integrity, both can be used, authentication header or ESP, used end to end, while original IP header inside tunnel or without original IP header in the transport mode. Oracle is the IKE Internet Key Exchange Key Determination Protocol, and ISAKMP is the Internet Key Exchange Key Management Protocol. So we always require key management instead of key determination. That is the reason IKE version 2 uses the ISAKMP. So this is what the IP security. In IP security is mainly, that is the reason it is widely used in the establishment of virtual private networks and secure channels.